In this session, we are going to revise chapter 4, Geometry. First, we are going to revise 1 marks. The triangles ABC and PQR are similar. Can be written as the two triangles are similar. How can we write that? The triangle ABC is similar. This line is called the similar. So, this wave line denotes similar. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Clear? Second question. If two triangles are said to be similar, then the corresponding sides are dash. If they are given, you are going to write proportional. Proportional means what? Corresponding sides means what? If you take triangle ABC and PQR. So, how will you write? AB divided by PQ is equal to BC divided by QR. We will write, isn't it? So, that is the proportional. Proportional means divides. Okay. Next, third one. The triangles are equiangular. The triangles are dash if the corresponding angles are equal. The triangles are equiangular. Equiangular means it will have the same angle. Okay, then the corresponding angles are equal. Clear? Fourth one. A pair of equiangular triangles are similar. Similarly, equiangular triangles means it will comes under the similar only. Fourth one. A pair of equiangular triangles are similar. Clear? Now, fifth one. If two triangles are similar, then they are what? Equiangular. Okay, here the third point itself, we have said that the corresponding sides are equal, then it is equiangular. Similar, if the corresponding sides are equal means what? Then it is a similar only, no? So, fifth one, if two triangles are similar, then they are equiangular. Here, sixth one, your circles are dash. Circles also similar. Circles are dash if they are given, you are going to write similar. Seventh one. All squares are similar. All squares are dash. If they are given, similar. Clear? Eighth one. All dash triangles are not congruent. Congruent is different. Similar is different. In the first part, one topic itself, we have learnt about congruent and similar. Isn't it? If you need, you can go through the part 1 video regarding similar and congruent. Okay? All similar triangles are not congruent. But in the 9th question, if you see, all congruent triangles are similar. Here, all similar triangles are not congruent in 8th question. But in 9th question, all congruent triangles are similar. Clear? Next, 10th one. A straight line drawn dash to a side of a triangle divides the other two sides proportionally. This concept where we have learned? Yes, we have learned in basic proportionality theorem. So, a straight line drawn parallel to a side of a triangle divides the other two sides proportionally. Here, a straight line drawn dash if they are given, the side of a triangle divides the other two sides proportionally means in the dash what will you write? Parallel. 11th one. Basic proportionality theorem is also known as, when I am teaching basic proportionality theorem, I have told you in 3 ways we can say the theorem. What are the 3 ways we can say? We can say it as basic proportionality theorem or else BPT theorem. BPT. BPT theorem or else what we can say? Thales theorem, I have told you, isn't it? Basic proportionality theorem is also known as Thales theorem. Clear all of you? Friends, see, this is the remaining 1 marks. Where you are going to read this 1 mark question is, you are going to see the exercise 5.5 in your maths book. Okay, exercise 5.5, page number 195 and 196 it will be. Clear? See, the first question you answer, this is the option. Option 1, option 2, option 3, option 4, 4 option you will be having. This red color under question number. Okay, this third one, option 3, angle B equal to angle D. Second one answer is option 2, 70 degree. Third one option is third one answer is option 4, 5:2 centimeter. Fourth one answer is option 1, 25:2 ratio. 25 divided by 2. Ratio means divided by 4, it's mean. Fifth question is option 4, 15 centimeter. Sixth question is option 1, 1.4 centimeter. Seventh question is option 2, 4 centimeter. Okay, for this 7 questions, you are going to see the question from your book, and these are the answers you can mark in your book. If you need, you can solve and see the same answer only you will get. Here, next we'll talk about now 2 marks questions. Next, we are going to see about similar triangles. This is the first concept we have learned in chapter 4 geometry, isn't it? See, I have taken triangle ABCPQR. If the two triangles are similar, then how can we write now? Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Then which means angle A. Here also angle 1, here also angle 1. So angle A is equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q, angle C is equal to angle R. If the two triangles are similar, then we can write the corresponding sides are what? Proportional. Proportional means what? AB. For this AB side, what is the corresponding side? PQ. So how can we write now? AB divided by PQ is equal to BC divided by QR is equal to CA divided by RP. Okay, clear? Similar triangle means same shape but not same size. We have learned in the first introduction of the chapter 4 geometry. Isn't it? Do you remember? If you need the full explanation, you can go through the part 1 video. Then along with the similar triangle, next concept we have learned about congruent triangle. Congruent means how will you represent congruent triangle? Congruent means we will represent by one wavelength, then equal to. This is like we will represent the congruent. Congruent means what? Same shape and same size. Okay, if the first triangle, if you are taking the same shape and same size, means the second side triangle also should be same shape and same size. Clear? Next criteria of similarity we have learned, isn't it? What are the criteria we have learned? Now what are the criterions we have learned? AA criterion, SAS criterion, SSS criterion, SS criterion, isn't it? So AA criterion means what? Angles are equal. So in the first triangle, if this angle, then angle. So if equal, then according to AA criterion, we can say that the two triangles are similar and we can write the corresponding sides in the same ratio. Isn't it? The next criterion is what? Next criterion is what? SAS criterion, which means, how can we say it? SAS criterion means side, angle, side. Similarly, side, angle, side. That is the SAS criterion. Then last one is SSS criterion. SSS criterion means if you take two triangles, then all the side AB is equal to PQ, BC is equal to QR, then CA is equal to AB. All the sides will be equal in SSS criterion. Clear students? First we have seen about similar triangles. Then using the criterion we have solved the problems. Isn't it? Next we are going to see some useful results on similar triangle. In your book if you see, you are having nearly 4 to 5 some results you are having. But main 5 results you are having. But main result we will use here is very important is 1 and 2. These two are very, very important. See what they were saying, two triangles are similar. See, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. Then the ratio of the corresponding sides are equal. Ratio means what I have told you in previous classes. Ratio means divide. The corresponding sides are equal, which means what? Divides. So AB divided by DE. For AB, the corresponding side will be what? DE. Then BC divided by EF. then AC divided by DF. Clear like that? You have to write the corresponding sides are equal to the ratio of the corresponding perimeters. Listen carefully what you are given. Perimeters. Perimeter means the corresponding sides is equal to the perimeter. Perimeter means all the three sides you have to add in the triangle ABC. So in the triangle ABC, what are the three sides you will be having? Tell me. What are the three sides? The first triangle we will be having here A, here B, here C. Isn't it so? AB plus BC plus CA. We will write. Isn't it? That only I have written. Next in triangle we are having DEF. So if you are taking DEF, so what will you write the perimeter? DE plus EF plus FD. Clear? That only they were saying in the first question. In the question paper, if they are asking either in 2 marks perimeter means, you are going to apply this rule. Okay? First you have to verify that triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. Then after verifying, you have to write the corresponding guides. It's in the equal, corresponding sides are equal. That format you have to write. Then only you have to come to this step. Here, now second one is, if the ratio of the area, now first one is perimeter, second one is area. Here, if the ratio of the area of two similar triangles are equal, okay, then to the ratio of the square of the corresponding sides. If the area of the two triangles are similar, means how it can be write is, the square of the corresponding sides. Okay, here we have written the corresponding side as such, isn't it, in perimeter. But in the area, the square of the corresponding sides they have given, which means AB divided by AB square divided by PQ square equal to BC square divided by QR square equal to AC square divided by PR square. Okay, both are very very important. If in the question paper perimeter given, so you are going to apply this rule. If the question paper they have given area, means you are going to apply this rule. Clear? The next concept we are going to learn about here is basic proportionality theorem, or we can say it as Thales theorem. Clear? Students, basic proportionality theorem and Thales theorem, converse of basic proportionality theorem. We are totally, how many theorem we are having? We are having, now so far we have learned only two theorems. Isn't it? The first theorem is BPT theorem. That is basic proportionality theorem. Here, next one is Thales theorem. We can say it as Thales theorem, or converse of Thales theorem we can say. Clear? Now we will see about that. Now we are going to see about theorems, which is BPT theorem. BPT theorem full form is what? Basic proportionality theorem. Next theorem is what? Converse of BPT theorem. So far you have learned two theorems, isn't it? But in your chapter 4 geometry, nearly are having 6 theorems. But the first 1-2 theorem only you have learned. Students, how will the question will be asked in your test or in exam means state and prove. How they will ask you means state and prove. Either they can say BPT theorem, otherwise they can say basic proportionality theorem or Thales theorem they can say. Okay, if they were asking state and prove BPT theorem or Thales theorem, if they are given, means what you are going to do? First, you have to write this statement. Okay, statement. Inside that statement, what is the statement for BPT theorem? A straight line drawn parallel to a side of a triangle intersecting the other two sides divides the sides in the same ratio. Okay, that statement you are going to write here. After writing that, you have to write what is given. Okay, then what you are going to prove, that you are going to write. Then construction, main proof, ends proved. Clear? Till last line ends proved you have to write. Clear? Only then you will get full 5 marks with the diagram you are going to write. Clear? If the question they were asking state and prove basic proportionality theorem or state and prove Thales theorem, if they were asking, first you have to write the statement. Okay, statement means that I have written a straight line drawn parallel to that. You are going to write proof in that given. What is given? You have to write to prove. You have to write construction, main proof, then ends proved. You have to write. Clear? All those things if you are writing, only then you will get 5 marks. Clear? Next one is converse of BPT theorem. Converse of BPT theorem also, for that also you have to write statement, proof, statement, proof, given, to prove, construction, main proof, ends proof. Okay, if they are asking any one theorem, you have to write this according to that theorem. If the question is Thales theorem, for Thales theorem what statement is in your book, that statement only you are going to write. Clear students? Suppose in 2 marks if they are asking, write the statement of Thales theorem. If they are asking means you have to write only the statement. Clear? Statement of Thales theorem means only the statement you have to write. Similarly, if they are 2 marks, they were asking, write the statement of converse of BPT theorem means only the statement you have to write. Okay, in 5 marks only they will ask you state and prove converse of BPT theorem or state and prove basic proportionality theorem, like that they will ask you. Clear now? Students, in BPT basic proportionality theorem, what we have proved? We have proved AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC. Based on this, we have done more problems in exercise, isn't it? In exercise 4.2, we have did. Next, according to the corollary, how can we write the corresponding sides? AB, the full length divided by half AD, equal to full length AC divided by AE. Now, then another way, how can we write AB divided by DB, the remaining of DB is equal to AC divided by EC. Okay, which is convenient and which value we have to find, according to that we can take any one. Clear? Now, in converse of BPT, what we have learned, they are given. Okay, in BPT they have given ADE is parallel to BC. They have given, we have proved AD divided by DB is equal to AE divided by EC. But in converse, they have given to prove this value. They have given. We have to prove DBF is parallel to DE. We have to prove. Clear? That is the difference between BPT and converse of BPT. Clear students? When you are reading both the theorem, read it thoroughly. Okay? Next, we will see the pattern for the test. Students, this is your pattern. If you see, choose, you are going to get 5 choose. Each question carries 1 mark. That is the room letter 1. So, 5 marks. Room letter 2 is 2 marks. So, 5 questions will be given. You have to write all the 5 questions. Clear? Each question carries 2 marks. Third subdivision is 5 marks. They will be given 3 questions. Out of 3 questions, you have to write only 2 questions. So, 2 5s are 10. So, total mark is 25. Here, students, I have gave you 1 marks, 18 1 marks, isn't it? I have written 11 1 marks and I ask you to refer exercise 4.5 1 marks. 7 1 marks, first 7 1 marks, isn't it? So, totally 18 1 marks you are having. You get thorough in the 18 1 marks. Clear? Next, in 2 marks and 3 5 marks, you are going to learn exercise 4.1 1 to 9 problems. Okay? First problem to 9 problems, 9th problem. Work out all the 9 problems. Okay? Thoroughly work out. Read the question. What is the condition for similar? What does the Thales theorem say? What is the converse of Thales theorem say? Enter all the concepts in the mind, then you can start working. Clear? Then exercise 4.2, 1 to 7 problem. First problem to 7 problems, you work out and see. Students, if you are understanding the concept thoroughly, it means very, very easy for you to work out these problems. Clear? So work out only very less amount of problem you are having. So now itself, if you get thorough, it means it will be very easy for you for writing next portions. Okay? Surely the next portion you will be having much more than this portion, isn't it? So now itself, if you get thorough in this, means it will be easy for you to get good marks in the further test also. Clear, students? Do well test, all of you. All the best for you. Thank you, students.